Welcome back, TAOFLEDER folks. Jeff and Officer Greg back out here with you on a ridiculously windy day. I'm covered in flour from an earlier shoot. This is not cocaine, I promise you. Hey, today we're bringing you the Orion Flare Gun. You've seen these before on this channel. You've probably seen them hanging on the wall in Walmart. They are designed for marine signaling for emergencies. I carry this thing during backpacking trips in case I ever needed to emergency signal anyone to for help. So, one of the things about the Orion 12-gauge pistol is that it's chambered in 12 gauges. Does that make any sense? I think it encourages people to put the wrong kind of shells in there and possibly do damage to themselves. Now, you'll notice that the flares that come with the Orion 12-gauge are tapered. This little flare here is essentially acting as its own barrel. It does not actually contact the barrel of the pistol. It just fires down this plastic tube. But you can see the base of the tube looks just like a 12-gauge round. So the flare fits in there flush and fires out just perfectly. We are going to show you today how a 12-gauge round, a standard old military 12-gauge round, put into the Orion, is designed not to seat. See that right there? You cannot close this, and that's probably a smart thing, because you can imagine what would happen if you fired this thing off in your hand. We're actually going to do that too, just not with our hands. Now, one thing I don't think Orion accounted for was the fact that people make these mini shells. This one's from Warwolf. You've seen them here before on TAOFLEDERMAUS channel. This is a mini buck round. This buckshot round will chamber in the Orion. It will close, and OG is not going to pull the trigger on this. We're going to tie a string to it, send it downrange, and see if we can blow the crap out of this thing. See if we can blow it up. So let's get to it. We're going to show you a couple little tricks with the flare gun first before we destroy the little gun, the host gun.
For your own safety, do not attempt this yourself.
So the standard Orion flare into the standard Orion flare gun.
Okay, ready. Oh, not the table.
All right, this was shot at around 10 yards away. It's a really good example of why you should never use one of these against a living person. I actually saw a video on YouTube of somebody shooting their friend with this exact flare gun, and that is just stupid. Please don't do that stuff. In our previous video where we shot the flare into the ballistic gel with a shotgun, people wanted us to shoot it out of just the regular flare pistol and get a chronograph reading. So we got 424 feet per second out of the pistol. It was my belief that we wouldn't see much of a difference in the velocity out of a longer barrel shotgun simply because the diameter of the flare itself is so much smaller than the diameter of the barrel. So in reality, we got more than 100 feet per second more velocity out of the shotgun. I guess I'd rather be wrong and respected for being honest than being a know-it-all and not get any respect. The accuracy out of the shotgun really wasn't much better at this range than out of the pistol. These flares are rather light, they're not very aerodynamically sound, and they do tumble around quite a bit.
Flare in little Tony. And big Tony, your stocks are on their way.
I didn't forget. I was trying to get another signature today, but it didn't happen. Oh, right through it.
Right through it.
212.
What?
I don't know.
On this shot, we moved the target much closer. It's about 10 feet away this time. The accuracy at this range was much better, and as you could see, it had no problem going right through that big block of clay. And people did want us to shoot the clay with a flare, so there you go. And finally, a lot of people wanted to know what would happen if you tried to shoot a live shotgun shell out of this 12-gauge flare gun. Now, it's just my opinion that this flare gun should have never been chambered in 12-gauge to begin with. But because we now have these 12-gauge mini shells, which have been around for about 20 years, Aguila has been making them for that long, now you can actually chamber a live shotgun shell into this flare pistol. And today we're going to show you just how dangerous this really is. The gun will be triggered remotely, and both Greg and I will be behind ballistic paneling. The number two buckshot coming out of this barrel is almost ineffective. Now the irony here is the person shooting the gun is putting himself under more danger than someone that was standing in front of the gun being shot. Now the chamber pressure on a normal shotgun is around 12,000 psi. It didn't even take that much pressure for this chamber to blow up. Now most of the shrapnel did fly upwards, some of it flew downwards, but of course that doesn't mean if we shot 10 of these guns it's going to behave exactly in that same manner.
Okay, so here's what we found just as we found it. Blew out the top of the barrel, which is kind of expected. This is why you do not want to have your hands on one of these things. We pulled it with a string about 3 miles long. You can see over here the number two buckshot sprinkled up against this aluminum, but did not leave even a dent. They just transferred their paint right onto the yellow aircraft. This thing, along with some other shards that we can't find, came raining down on us on our trucks over there to the left rear. So it blew the back out of this.
The whole brass base of the shell.
You can see here the tilt-up barrel still works.
Does it still fire?
It will still fire.
Hey, yeah. To come up with this, to do this safely.
It's science, folks.
Yeah, there you go. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for donating that pistol, Greg.
Hey, there you go. Your next Patreon giveaway, Jeff.
I don't know if I can ship that, but I can ask.
Oh, it's perfectly legal down at Walmart.
That's true.
Not a firearm, so.
Yeah, it's been demilled now.
It has definitely been demilled. All right, patrons, this is coming your way.
Anyway, I hope you enjoyed that video. I apologize for the annoying wind noise. It was very windy that day. Again, I emphasize, do not try this at home for your own safety. This was done under very safe conditions. Thanks for watching.